Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today back in Banish, where we are trying to stave off starvation. We've got zero food. I think I'm narrowly avoiding the food crisis, but that doesn't matter, because if you look down here, a tornado has touched down near the town, and I fear the worst for our citizens of Underbold. They will have fought for nothing, because soon they will be wiped off the face of the earth. There it is. It's huge. It's heading straight for the center of town, no less. It's gonna just terrorize our population. Watch, we started with like 45 people. No, like 56 people. Look how many deaths there are. It's really just cleaning up. I hope you didn't need this storage barn, because it now stands in between the tornado and its true target, the rest of the citizens. We're down to under 30 now. Still counting. Oh, there goes the fishing dock. Didn't need that anyway. Do you want to take the trading post while you're at it, you menacing beast? It does. It does. I'm so sad. There's nothing I can do. It doesn't matter that we've built four beautiful new small coastal wood houses on the river. Game doesn't care. It just got done destroying most of our town. We only have 24 people left. There's just not enough spaces in the cemetery for all of these dead bodies. Well, what a way to start a video. You know, I was hoping to start building a castle today. I was hoping for a lot of good things that were just completely ruined. But we're gonna do what we can to salvage this steaming pile of death and try to make things better. After literally hours of playtime, we're talking over three decades in-game have passed since the tornado incident, I finally recovered to the point where Underbold has stabilized, both in terms of food as well as every other resource. Tools especially was problematic. There was at least a decade or two there where I just couldn't get a supply of tools. People were just walking around banging on rocks with their hands in the mines. They couldn't pull out enough iron to allow me to make tools that were necessary. Finally, I've erased the kink in the system, which was uneducated citizens. So we've got a schoolhouse who's actively training our children to be efficient at their jobs. That took at least a decade just to get right. And now I think we can finally progress. I've also got a town hall over here, so that's a pretty important step in the right direction. We can accept nomads if we find them. I can keep track of my inventory a lot better. You guys know the drill. I'm in the process of demolishing this forester's lodge right now, because I want to use this new spot for one of the new items from the mods. The bank barn, I think, will fit here. It was formerly going to go up here, if you recall, but I thought that was just too good of a spot for the town hall, and so it is. That's why we are now going to place it where the Forester's Lodge was. I don't think we need that Forester's Lodge here any longer. We have one fairly nearby that's a lot more productive, I think. And the bank barn is going to be useful because we also have a market, I guess I should point out, which is nearly full. I've made a lot of advancements because I wanted to make a lot of the buildings you guys have already seen me make 20 times before, so that when we come back, which is now, I can start working on some of these brand new structures, and we actually have the infrastructure to support it. I've got over 10 people, I believe, working on stone cutting, and that's going to be one of the primary resources we need for the bank barn. So we should have plenty to work with now, and that is what the whole point of this little mini-series is, of course. Let's see, what else is new? I'm not really sure. It's you know, over three decades of in-game time, it all kind of runs together. Oh yes! My little coastal houses! Aren't they beautiful? I've got a whole bunch near this fishing dock, thanks to the fountain mod I think this is from. And we've got a new boarding house over here. And we've got a root cellar. That's also one of the new additions. This can hold fruits and vegetables. I've got some new additions to our pastures to show you. Take a look at the bison. One of the new animals who are providing us with the specialized bison tenderloin, as well as leather. And over here we've got some very exemplary cows who are giving us milk. And milk is one of the big additions of the Colonial Charter mod, because we can use a very special building to turn it into cheese and cream and butter. And I think a great spot for this milk house is gonna be around the new part of town over here, because we don't really have anything else to go over here anyway, so we may as well make the most of this future market area. I got a couple spots for houses here, but we don't have any rope, unfortunately. Still have not been able to find any. Perhaps this will be our lucky break. We got cucumber seats. That is not what I ordered from you. I've been making custom orders from these guys, but alas, they just never give me what I want. What I want is wheat and tobacco, and we've got sunflower seeds already. Yes, I actually have purchased a couple different seeds, and flax and hemp would be amazing. Corn wouldn't be bad, but I don't want to waste my order on that. Barley certainly would help us out in making some rope, probably. I don't know what I'm saying. Barley is used for the watermill and turned into flour, which is in use in the bakery. So if you remember, I wanted to make a bakery and start making some bread, but that's very dependent on the RNG aspects of the merchants. So the one thing that is in my control is milk house, so we're going to have to settle for turning milk into cream, I guess. I don't know. That sounds good enough to me. That's a new supply chain that we're going to be taking advantage of. Now, one other thing that we're going to be able to look at is the bank barn. It finished while I wasn't looking. Looks pretty snazzy. Thing is huge. Look at it compared to the normal storage barn. Like, this just really does look like something someone who just learned how to cut wood would make. And this looks like the master craftsmen have stepped in to add a little finesse to our storage utilities. The milk house is complete. I always seem to miss these. This is what happens at 10 times speed. You don't get to appreciate the building process as much if you look away for any length of time. So we're going to start making cream, I think. Adding a worker here. We can have up to 2 workers, and looks like someone else was just turned into a laborer. So let's start making that happen. I think cream can go into the bakery as well as butter and cheese, but I'm not sure if we really have the final materials to be able to do anything else with it. So we're just going to have to settle for cream right now, I guess. I don't know. We need a bakery is what I'm trying to say, but the bakery's not going to help us without the ability to use flour or walnuts or something like that. So there's one of the other new structures, and we're going to, I think, start construction on the ultimate building added by these mods, a castle. Yeah, that's exciting, isn't it? Oh, but before that, let's make a fountain. We have the fountain mod. We need to make sure that we use its namesake, don't you think? I think the perfect spot for a large fountain is right in the center of this little square. It's not in the center of town, but it is a nice open spot where I doubt much else could really fit. So I kind of want to place it towards the barn, I guess. And we also need to finish paving these roads, don't you think? Because if we do that, it's just going to make everything look so much nicer. So I'm going to just drag out the stone roads all the way down, connect it to our little bridge. The whole point of this is to connect it to the bridge in the first place. So let's make sure that we take advantage of that situation. And once all these are connected, we'll have what looks like an actual town and not just make-believe pretend. Since we haven't gotten to watch anything else be built, why not start with a large fountain? Because apparently our builder is very dedicated to this fountain. And it does look really nice, I gotta say. I'm really impressed with all of these mods. It's fun just having new things to look forward to when you play Banished, you know? It's pretty crazy to think about how many months it's been. And yeah, these have been ready for a little while now. I know that these mods have been up for at least a month or two. But still, it was so long after release. So many people gave up on it, myself included. And to go back and kind of relearn how to play and just sit here and soak it all in, it just feels so good. I have to apologize to you guys because I specifically said we were going to watch the fountain be built and I got distracted and now it's completed and I'm so very sorry. But we did get to see it in progress, so that's got to count for something, right? I think it looks great. I love that it has different textures for every season. That's attention to detail if I've ever seen it. Get out of here with your nasty vending, trading stuff that nobody wants. They won't give me the items that I really need, and I'm very sad about that. See, it was wintry, and now it's not wintry. Good, I like that. That's great. They've copied what Banished has done in giving every building different looks based on the season and the weather, and I do wish that it had an animated water texture, but that's okay. We will forgive it. It still looks very nice and completes the look of the town. It can probably be used to put out fires, one would assume. Okay, so our next decision is a big one. We're going to be making a castle. The reason that most of you guys are probably here is now at hand. I believe it is in the Town Services tab where we will find our stone castle, and I've decided to place it right in the center of town. And I think it's identical on both sides, so it doesn't matter which side's the front and which side's the back. However, I think we still have just enough space. It's a little bit bigger than the market in terms of width, but the height, I believe, is identical. So there we have the stone castle in place. It takes 600 stone, 80 iron. 80 iron is pretty generous. That's not much. And a mere 250 logs. Probably going to need a little bit of extra forestry, so I've added one more forester because we need 250 logs. That's more than we currently possess. I want to make sure we don't run low on firewood. And it looks like we have some nomads who have visited the town hall for the first time ever in Underbolt. Also, I'm going to pause for just a second because we got some other important matters to attend to. Pumpkin seeds are here. You know, we got to get those seeds, 2,500, and I've actually got enough materials to trade with now. Silkworm cocoons are pretty valuable at 8 apiece, so they're worth 2,400 just by themselves. And I'm not using the silkworm cocoons for anything else at the moment, though if I had the materials, the rope specifically to upgrade into a clothier, then we would be using silk for clothes. However, since I'm not, they're a great trading utensil. So let's go ahead and utilize some of these coats, I think. I just need, like, 7 or 6. One more, we'll do the trick. And then we will have our pumpkin seeds. We can dismiss him. Now let's take a look at the nomads. We've got 15 nomads. That's such a small number. We're definitely going to allow them in immediately. We have 12,000 food in storage. That's plenty. And we've got a boarding house that they can live in while they're integrating into society. Italics planned ahead, you know? I got this under control. So we got all these laborers. Got plenty of stuff for them to do. Let's take off one of the builders. We're going to add a hunter. A couple foresters. Maybe, I don't know, another vendor back. A new miner. Stonecutter, we just like to spread them out nice and even, and we'll even get a couple on food just to make sure that they carry their own weight around here so that we don't suddenly have a huge food shortage on our hands. Then we'll leave one extra laborer to cart around materials and resources and help us where we need it most. Alright, so we've already got all the logs placed in. We don't have much left over in our stockpile, but I think we'll be able to cope now that I've filled up our foresters with 8 out of 8. Stone is underway. That's going to take us a while to mine out all that stone. And then we got 3,000 building units. Woohoo, boy. Now, while that's going on, the other big building that I want to show you is from the other mod, the fountain mod. The castle, I guess, is from the fountain mod also. I don't know why I tried to distinguish those two things. The biggest and the coolest looking buildings are from the fountain mod, but the most utility buildings are from the colonial mod, I think. So like the milk house and the bread and the wheat, being able to grind it down into flour and yeah, you get the idea. Functionality or cool, when you combine them, you get both. So why not have both? All right, the other building that I want to mention is also in the town services. It is an inventor workshop, which I guess does have some utility since it can make paper, ink, and some blueprints. I don't know what that means, blueprints, but this looks pretty cool. We're going to kind of place it towards the waterfront. I was thinking about placing the castle over here, but instead we have just the perfect spot for the inventor's workshop, and I'm trying to kind of feel it out. Where should it go? I think right there. We're going to pause construction on this because we don't want to completely run out of resources just yet, and I also want to keep an eye on the stone castle because I want to see the foundations go up. And with just the right amount of 391, we get our hemp seeds. It's very important for us to have. I'm going to start growing it pretty much immediately. Forgot we had pumpkins also. Hemp is going to be useful in the other supply chains in making rope. A very important task. We're not going to be able to look at it in this video, I don't think. But with hemp, you can turn it from hemp into rope through the ropery resource production building. The castle's certainly no joke. We're only at 120 out of 3,000, so it's going to be a while. Started construction on the Inventor's Workshop, thinking that perhaps we'll have the 80 stone necessary by the time that this is done, maybe even before. Who knows? There's also a colonial manor that I want to see built with rope through the ropery. We've got our first yield of hemp, hopefully. Let's take a look and see if we have any at our disposal. Got 284 to work with, so the crops are growing. How exciting. There's so many cool new things. All right, so is the ropery underway? Let's build that as well simultaneously. They don't need that much stone. We've got a whole 15 stone cutters at any given time. Are we at 15,000 food? That's really impressive, actually. You know, that's the exact reason why I built the bank barn, so that it could hold everything for us. Let's up that count even higher. We need to go higher. The castle is now one-third done, and you can see it has advanced in its visuals. A little bit higher up. Love the detail there. Very nice. We're over 1,000 of the way there. This is taking quite some time. We've accepted some new nomads into the fold, so they should be able to help us out. We have 8 builders now working. Let's make sure all of our food is currently maxed. We're probably going to need to start making some more here very soon. We just increased the population by like 10%. It's going to be important for us to do that. The question is how. I wish I could use the bakery, but alas, I cannot. So instead, I think it's wise to perhaps make another crop field, because we do have some ungrown pumpkins at the moment. I may or may not have accepted another group of nomads to help out with this huge project. Now we got 10 builders on the job and the castle is done. The first part of town may have a town hall, but here is the seat, the throne of King Talix. Here he shall divvy out all of his work orders. And now the 10 builders can be reduced a little bit, probably. Though, to be honest, I don't have too many other places to put them except maybe mining. I don't know. I'll take a look at that here in just a minute. The point is, the stone castle does act as a town hall. Gives you all the functionality of a town hall. That's pretty much all it is there for. Just to be a wonder, to look incredible. And it does look pretty incredible. Now, I could go even a step further and start building up some custom walls around my city. But I'm not going to have the time to do that here. You can see those walls right here. You can make it look as fancy as you want it to. Gatehouses, like I've already shown you. That looks awesome. Oh, the inventor's workshop is also done while I wasn't looking. This thing really looks fancy compared to every other building. This looks too modern. This wood is, like, nice and polished. I have no idea how to use this either. We can make paper, ink, or blueprints. I have no idea what this is, but we're going to have an inventor here. Hopefully he is educated. And we should have plenty of wood and water to make paper with. Don't even know. Maybe you can trade with it. Either way, just another cool building that you guys can take a look at. Building overload here in this video, as the ropery is also complete. So now we've got somebody making rope out of hemp. We need hemp, not flax. And then once we have that hemp into rope, we can make colonial manors, and then we can make the colonial houses. And we've got the inn going in nearby so that some of our new nomads have a place to live. Exciting times here in Underbold. Hope you guys have enjoyed this little mini-series on Banished. I think this is going to be the final capstone episode. We've got all the biggest buildings here for you viewing pleasure. Hope you guys have enjoyed it as much as I have revisiting this game, taking a look at some of the mods. There's many more where this came from. Take a look at the Steam Workshop or various other websites if they're not hosted on the Steam Workshop. Oh, our inventor already died. That means there must have been some invention gone wrong. He's using logs and bison tenderloins together. What kind of crazy explosion will that make? Who knows? That would be cool if it just erupted in a giant fireball. Thank you guys so much for watching this video series. If you enjoyed it, let me know your thoughts below. My name is Italix, and I will see you next time.